episode of FemmeTalk. Today I have my lovely, beautiful fiance, LT here.
The fiance.
And we're going to be talking about the five love languages. So we took the couple's version of the quiz. There is like different versions of the quiz that you can take depending. I guess the questions cater to the person. But we're going to get into what our top, I guess, first actually I'll tell you what the five acts are, or sorry, the five love languages are. So there's acts of service, quality time, words of affirmation, physical touch, and receiving gifts. So,
what was your top one?
Yeah.
No. What was your top?
All right. My top one was acts of service.
Oh, mine was words of affirmation.
That's very, like, I want to say typical.
What do you mean typical?
Because I feel like, I'm always like, babe, can you help me? Babe, can you do this
for me? Yeah.
Babe, and you're just like.
I think sometimes people look at me like, oh, is she that needy? But I don't see it as something like, I don't know, I like doing stuff for you. You know what I mean? And I know that it helps you, it makes you feel good, so.
Honestly, you just like saved my life half the time. If you weren't as on top of helping me with certain things at certain moments, I couldn't be as successful at what I'm doing right now at all. Like,
I got you.
True facts.
I got you.
Sometimes I'll be rushing out the door and I haven't had breakfast yet, and she'll pack me a little like lunch to go. Like, she does the sweetest shit for me, I swear to God.
You guys take notes.
Savage. Yeah, I mean, even with self-tapes, like, as an actor, I need somebody to constantly feed me lines. Mm-hmm. Sometimes she sits on the other side of the camera, feeds me my lines. She has to go through, like, tons of self-tape auditions with me. That is time that I know she does not want to spend doing this stuff. But she really, like, saves my life doing it, for real.
No, I got you. I told you. I know that it helps, so, and I know that that's something that's important to you, you know, so I'm there for you.
So why words of affirmation for you?
Because I think, like, I believe that you should, when you speak, that what you say should mean something. So, especially coming from my partner, like, words of affirmation mean something to me because it's like, you took the time to think of what it was to say, you thought about me before you said it, and like, you spoke it out there. You know what I mean? So
that's
like,
what you think. And then you met me. Guys, I'm the worst. I have a sharp tongue, I'm not gonna lie, and I don't always think about what I'm gonna say. I just get angry.
Sharp.
Real angry. But then she brings me back to level grounds and she's like, she checks me, yeah. She checks me from time to time. And she's like, was that coming from a place of love? And I'll just sit there and be like,
at first, she'll get madder.
It's like the veins in my forehead go off. I'm like, what did you say? And then I realize it's like, it's facts.
Yeah. What was your second one though?
Quality time.
Oh, what was the score?
Eight.
Mine was a 7, but that was third. My second one was physical touch.
Yeah, I'm so busy all the time. I definitely like to spend quality time with you. Mm-hmm. My downtime with you is like prized. It makes me feel complete and whole again. Mm-hmm. It's like, it's almost like I get to like cuddle up and like recharge, revamp.
Yeah,
it's like before I go back into the world again.
Yeah. I like that. Like, I don't know, we get to like reconnect when we spend quality time together.
That's why you like cuddles, eh? Physical touch.
Yo.
I see it. Her cuddles are self-serving.
Yo, she loves cuddles.
Her cuddles are self-serving.
Listen, the first time I met her.
Physical touch is fourth last. Fourth last for me.
Yeah. What was the first thing you said? I don't really like to cuddle.
I did say that. That's a big fact. I was like, I'm not really an affectionate person. I don't really like when people touch me too much. I'm really not into cuddling.
Mm-hmm. I broke that down though.
She did. She's the only one that can touch me. I still give awkward hugs, guys.
Yeah, even to me sometimes.
Yeah, I'm so awkward sometimes. Mm-hmm. It's so funny.
That's okay. What was your last one?
Receiving gifts.
Same.
Yeah, I've never been a like lavish me with stuff type girl.
No.
I don't know. I'm just like, show me you love me. Prove to me you love me. Tell me you love me.
Tell me.
Don't buy me something. I can buy my own stuff. Boss lady right here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm just not materialistic in that way.
You know? No, you're not.
Like, plus two, I have that feeling of like, if I want something that like costs money and stuff, like I want to work for it.
Like, yeah, I want to be like pride in having nice things that you earned yourself. Mm-hmm. but she's really non-materialistic, like to the point where like some of her t-shirts and shorts got to go. I've been trying to get her to throw out some certain pairs of shorts. And she's like, no, I like them, they're comfortable.
Listen, because they're functional still.
Functional.
That's how I grew up.
They're scrubby.
That's how I grew up.
All right, well, we're gonna be back in the second half talking about some more juicy stuff. Stay tuned. In your touch, won't you hold me now? I haven't felt like a flower falling on my knees for you. So why do I still crumble now? Why do I? Alright, so we're back and I'm just gonna get right into it. So babe,
go for it.
Was it love at first sight for you?
I don't believe in love at first sight with my definition of love.
Got it.
Yeah.
So what's your definition of love?
Oh man, that's deep. We don't have enough time for that. But like, I think that like the definition that I have of love when I think of like being in love with someone, it's past like the initial like infatuations and all that kind of stuff when you like settle into, okay, what do you want to do in life? What do I want to do in life? How can we work together in life to do this? Like
the bigger picture.
Yeah, way bigger picture. Like it's being there for you when, you know, at your low days or my highest days and knowing that you got my back. Like there's so much more to it than like, I don't know, love at first sight. But
so
what do you think?
So wait, if I were to ask you though, when you seen me, was it love at first sight? You would say no.
I wouldn't say it was like love at my definition of at first sight, but there was definitely like a, like, like I remember the exact moment that you walked into the room at Sierra's condo, you know, and it was like, I was sitting there and you walked in with like this big hair and this big smile, but we made eye contact and it was like, I don't know, I just saw so much more than just like what was there. And I felt like really like automatically almost at home and deeply connected with that. So.
That's some deep shit.
Yeah, and I was right.
That's some deep shit. Shoot, that left me kind of speechless. Yeah. Okay, love at first sight. Well, I agree on that with the whole love at first sight. I don't really think I believe in love at first sight. Like, cause I have a deeper meaning for love. I definitely feel like my meaning and my view on love has changed because of you. The idea that I had before was much more simplistic, and it wasn't, I didn't even know, I guess, what I needed for myself in order to thrive in the way that I wanted to thrive.
Mm-hmm.
So you were able to show me what I even needed for myself, if that made sense.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, for me, love goes beyond even what you think it is at times. Like, you showed me a love that I now want.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it definitely, for me, wasn't like, my idea of love at first sight still wasn't, it didn't just bloom like that right away.
No.
It wasn't just like a, oh my god, I'm in love, starstruck.
Nah, you were starstruck.
Nah.
Basketball player from the States.
So, would you say it was more of an energy vibe or a sexual attraction off the bat?
For me, like, the energy part was there, obviously.
I mean,
like,
that sounds pretty, it sounds like a dumb question,
right?
I mean, like, I get it.
You're
it's
not
it's
ugly,
a deep
you
energy.
Know?
But that's crazy.
So tell
well,
me about you.
I'm gonna say, my experience was completely different, I'm not gonna lie. But I think it's because we were in different places at the time, too.
Mm-hmm.
I was how old again?
22.
I was okay, guys. I'm like fresh out of university. I'm still young, wild, and free. I'm working in the nightclub scene, like getting, you know, having too much fun, getting lit, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I was there to like go to a party, you know? I'm like, I'm trying to meet somebody, you know? Like have some fun, whatever, let loose, have a good time. And I definitely like walked into the room and right away it was like an attraction. Strong attraction, but I don't know if I would call it energy or if I'd call it libido. I liked what I saw and I was just like, oh, yo, it sounds so bad. I feel like I'm commodifying you. Like, it was like a car that I wanted to try. I was like, yo, that's
American
car.
Muscle, you know?
This is an American Muscle car. I want to get in it and try it.
What?
I can't believe I just said that.
Oh, man.
For real, no. I just was, like, really, like, sexually infatuated with you. I definitely, like, I think, honestly, I always say it was the first thing I said to her. The first thing wasn't even, hi, nice to meet you, my name is Cheyenne. No, it was, that jawline?
Yeah, she wasn't even talking to me. She was talking to someone else, but, like, she was talking to them, but then making eye contact with me as she said it. So I was like, oh, yeah.
Guys, I didn't even ask her name. I just sexually looked at her like a piece of meat. And here we are, almost 4 years later, yeah. So
yeah,
it was...
In like 2 weeks, it would be...
It's hard to say that love at first sight doesn't exist, because the attraction was there, and it was like, you know, there was energy and there was sexual attraction, so it was kind of a little bit of everything, and I mean, it's almost to me like it was love at first sight, but... Anyways, let us know what you guys think, and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Check out Crown Me TV. Check out Stub Talk, check out Fem Talk. Lots of crazy topics, lots of stuff to keep you on the edge of your seat. That's all for now, though.